Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at using hover text on your Mac to make text easier to read and type. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So hover text is an accessibility feature of macOS that allows you to see text on your screen, even if it's very small, and also allows you to type text even if the text entry font is really small as well. Now you'll find this in macOS Big Sur and Catalina. If you go to System Preferences and then to Accessibility, and then from there go to Zoom. Now an option in Zoom is Enable Hover Text. So we'll turn that on. Now you'll see instructions here that you hold the Command key down to see hover text. So let's give that a try. Now getting hover text to appear is a little odd, because you would think you would move your cursor over some text like this and then hold the Command key down. But in fact, you hold the Command key down first and then you move the cursor. So I'll hold the Command key down, and then if I move my cursor over text, you can see I get this enlarged version of the text. It's a lot easier to read. Obviously, it's huge. If I release the Command key, it goes away. So I have to basically hold the Command key down and move my cursor around the screen to see the hover text. Now there are some options here. Let's dig right into those. If I click Options, I could see I could set the text size, so I can make it smaller. It doesn't have to be that huge. I could change the font to any font I have installed. You could also change the modifier from Command to Option or Control if you want. And notice it says triple press to lock. So let's give that a try. If I triple press the Command key, then it says hover text locked. And now anywhere I move, I'm always going to see hover text. So I don't have to hold the Command key down anymore to see it. And it's easy just to turn this off with three presses on the same key. And now you're back to the mode where you have to hold the Command key or whatever the modifier key is down to see it. So let's say I'm looking at a web page like this. If I hold the Command key down and move around, I can see whatever text is underneath the cursor, but much larger, no matter what size the font is below. And you can see it will give me an entire paragraph or thereabouts as I move around. But it does even more than that. If I go over images, it will try to show me something there as well. So for instance, here I just see the caption of the image. Here there's no caption, so it gives me the file name. And you can see here it actually gives me the extra information included with the image. You can see it appear here when I move over the image normally. But with hover text turned on, you can see it shows me a large version. I also get descriptions of buttons, and sometimes they match what you get normally. Like for instance, if I move my cursor here, it will come up with a little share indicator there. But if I use hover text, you can see it gives me share large. This one says new tab, but this one here, you can see normally the subtext is show tab overview, but I actually get a deeper description from hover text. And here I get less of a description. So you don't always get the same information when you use hover text that you get normally when you move over a button. Now let's look at another aspect of hover text, and that's the ability to see the text that you're typing. So if I go into options here, I could see here I have text entry location, and I could set that to something like near the current line, top left, right, bottom left, bottom right, or custom spot. Let's say near the current line. Now when I go to type text, I actually can see what I'm typing. So the easiest way to do this is to turn on hover text by triple pressing the modifier key. So now it's locked on. And now when I start typing something, you can see I get this large entry area here that mirrors the regular text entry there. Now this will work in some places but not others. So for instance, if I try to type a new URL here, you can see it works there in Safari. If I try to use a search field here, I notice that sometimes it comes up and sometimes it doesn't. So it's kind of hit or miss on the internet. So in Pages here, when I start typing, it actually shows me a large portion of what I'm typing. So it makes it really easy to see here exactly what I'm typing, maybe even focus more on the actual words I'm typing rather than seeing a whole wall of words from the entire document. Now on Pages you can adjust the font to whatever size you want, and you can even zoom in. But you can't do that in an app like Messages. A lot of people ask me how they can make the text larger in Messages, but with hover text you don't have to. You can move your cursor over any piece of text and see a larger version of it. And when you type some text, you could see it larger using hover text as well. Now in hover text options, you can also set the text entry location to a regular point instead of having it cover stuff on the screen. So for instance, I could say appear at the bottom left. So now when I type something, it's always there at the bottom left and not covering up what I might want to see in the middle of the screen. And if you use custom, what you'll get is some text that'll appear here, and you can grab the left end here and drag it around and put it somewhere, and then it'll stay there. Now notice when I'm typing using hover text, I can put the cursor here and I can move around, but I could also click in here to place the cursor. Now you also have the ability here to go and set colors. So you can set the text color, you can set the insertion point color from when you're typing, the background color of hover text, the border color, and the element highlight color. So for instance, let's go and set the background to black and the text color to white. Now when I go to use hover text, you can see it looks like that. So give hover text a try if you ever find yourself having trouble reading text or seeing the text that you're typing. You could use it just about anywhere. You could see it here as I move around the MACMOST website. You can use it in places like Control Center. You can use it in the menu bar. It could be a really good solution if you occasionally have trouble reading some text in an app or two, but you don't really want to change the whole look of your screen just to accommodate that one app. Or if you're someone that needs reading glasses but find that most of the time you can use your Mac just fine without them, but every once in a while there's a word or some element that's hard to see. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.